Hi, and thank you once again for joining me for the reading for your week ahead. I'd like to get straight into this for you, Aries, and hope you do enjoy. Now, as we go down to the card upon the left, as you can see, we've got the Judgment card. And that is what we call our Resurrection card. Again, raising up against all problems you've had to face just recently. But again, you keep lifting up. Don't carry too much past around you with you with this card. It's about getting through things, rising up, making good decisions. And you know, this is what this week's about. It's getting through things and looking at things. Well, it's been a bit tough, but now I'm getting through there. So looking forward and facing a few things. From time to time, we have to face things and not carry too much of the past, deal with it and move on. We could see also that you do have the Queen of Pentacles. Now, that's a moderate wealth, is the Queen of Pentacles. Now, she likes what she's got in her lap, but she's also very generous. She likes to share her wealth. So again, you're having that bit of generosity side showing through you there, where you can share and divide. And you're very satisfied with what you've earned, and you've not got this given. You've earned it through very hard work, and I feel very perfectionistic in what you do. You like everything done perfectly and in order. As the Queen of Cups is there showing me that, you know, although you can have a side where you need your space, you need time for you to reflect, but also where the emotions of the cup is in there, you're soon up and you're about, and you know you rise up through all obstacles that's been placed in front of you there. And I feel that with the Queen of Cups, she carries a very good intuition. She likes to support and help others. So see in the coming week where you'll be giving your shoulder to someone who just needs that little bit of comfort from you. And you can do this and support them through all the hardship and problems that they've got coming up and around them. So see if you're not going to be used as a shoulder in the coming week. And I do see the Five then as a Five of Cups. It is always a middle card, is a Five of about. It's about not crying over spilt milk, you know, moving over that bridge, over the troubles that's been in front of you there. And you're able to know, although through difficult times, you do have others that's propped you up from occasionally. But again, I feel that this is a time that you'll be propping someone else up. And I know that you've been dedicated and hardworking and very loyal. You've also got a card that's giving you some opportunities in a work sense. Now, the opportunities can be on a golden path, but you have to be prepared to walk down these and, you know, and look what's in front of you, because some things, although you really are keen at being putting things right and in order, you want to make sure that this journey is worth taking. So you do have some potential there to go a lot further, and the journey ahead of you to bring you the opportunities. I see there they've got the Six of Cups also, so that's showing me an emotion around again. But supporting someone, as I've already said, but also having someone from your past getting back in touch. So it's about sharing memories and about getting together and having them discussions. So although I don't feel like we're going to ride you away for very much longer, I feel like you'd be out there joining in with new friends. I see also that the Lovers is there. Now that's piecing things together now, because I just feel like the Lovers, there's a strong bond and an intuition there once again to say that you know when something is right. You know when it's time to make the move. You know that when you go forward, you're going to go forward with confidence, because the Knight of Wands is there. Now the Knight of Wands is rising you up. Although you're ready to get going now, you're ready to get stuck back in and lifting up and moving forward. Also watch for change of direction where properly could be concerned, or a direction that we're moving you forward. Both senses I feel work for some, and again oomphs for others. Now I know this won't resonate, as I said many times, with everyone, but just take out the reading what you can. I do want to draw attention now to my magician. Now you've got your magician in your reading. He will always set the seeds, as I've said so many times. He sets the ideas. So although we're placing things high up, we're resurrecting here, we've also got the magician to put them ideas out, and you know, facing them. So you've got everything there to play with the magician. So it's bringing your ideas forward and your creativity. And I feel this will be done in a work sense also, showing you that your abilities, as you know, to appear things as that perfect link that you like to see done. Now, what I feel when I'm looking at this card is that I'm drawing back to the Lovers. Now, that also is about you using your intuition, your ideas, and sharing that. So Do know that, you know, you can rise up through these ideas, just place them forward. Now, draw your attention back to your major card I pulled for you at the back. That's the Empress, because you've got the Magician and the Empress there. Now, although the ideas are set there, the Empress, she likes to bring birth to them. So your ideas are being born. So don't be afraid to run with them and show them skills that you've got there, because this is what the High Priestess does. She's very lavish. She likes things. And this is what it's showing you, the ideas. In the middle row there, now I also call that my here and now cards, but I see there that the heart comes in. So although it can be the death of things, but I think the ideas have to come forward from new ideas. So getting rid of everything, because the resurrection judgment card came first, and that is telling me that you do have to put things down and end things for new things to begin. You also have to be very honest with yourself and with your ideas. Protect your ideas. Don't be going out there and, you know, if you've got a project, just be aware who you share that with, because you've got that thief in the night card, I say, and you don't want somebody else to run off with your ideas that you're now planning. So safeguard what's really important to you during this new change that's coming. You will put your back to certain things and emotions, and you'll go forward. But it's hard sometimes to place our back to what we know, our back to what we know we've got to do, and leave the people we love behind as well sometimes, or the ideas to move forward. But in order for us to grow, that's what we have to do. So it's about your challenges that you're facing in this coming week, with your ideas that wants to move you forward. The Queen of Swords is there now, right at the right-hand side at the top. She always likes to be in control. And again, she lectures, she tutors, she likes to put things out there. So you're going to be talking powerfully good things here, but you're definitely going to be in control of them also. So although you won't, we're looking at the middle where it's showing us to be a bit weary there, you do understand that very clearly that you can see the ones you do have to watch around you. So a very sharp eye there, very keen to get your ideas and nobody take them from you, because you're taking back your control. You're going to have a little bit of relaxed time as well, because the sun is out there for you. A bit of playtime, a bit of lightening up. So we're not making it all work. We're having a little bit of enjoyment upon this route as well. So happy times with family and a little bit of indulgence for you there. So share some good times. I see that the King of Pentacles is there. He's also materialistic, but he's also a very lovely king in a deck, because although he's mature, he's earned his wealth, he can also have that little bit of time to enjoy it, as the sun's coming out for you there, but also a time to enjoy. So a bit of spending upon yourself there. And it's a great card, as I've already said, to have, because it gives us that little bit of fortunes to know that we've earned what we've got, because pentacles are always down to earth. They're always grafters, they're hard workers. They'll support others around them as well. They're not frightened of doing that. And they're also very generous in helping someone else that may need a little bit of an helping hand. So you're there to support others as well. I see that the Hermit's bringing you out of the dark and into the light. And also, he's always my wise old man, who wants to go forward there with his ideas. So we're seeking other routes. We're seeking the ideas that we want to put into motions, but we're going to see where we're heading also, because that's what the Hermit does. And don't be afraid, don't isolate yourself. You know he won't let you, because the lamp is showing you the way. It's lighting up everything. So again, the ideas are being born. And I feel this is exactly where we're going. It's about what we want to do, because you picked up the Fool. Now the Fool is the naught. It's beginnings, ending of one thing and beginnings of new. So we're tracking a new road here. We're trailing along here with a Z high in the sky with the new ideas. But just be careful that you don't be overconfident. Make sure everything you've got by your Hermit lay, seeing everything before we make that move forward, because sometimes you will hold yourself back because you can't always see what is on this path that you're embarking on. All the ideas are there, all the times there, the powerful queen's there to say that, you know, you want to be in charge of this, it's your project, it's your baby. But you'll see where you're going to safeguard this, because sometimes we can't see everything. So if the road is worth, as I said already, with the opportunities that's arising, cover everything first, because there is a pathway and it's early in front of you. In order for you to go forward, you have to break through. But you also have to be a bit wary as well. And you've got to take the blinkers off to see what's ahead. Although there's a tiny few problems and situations do need ironing out, you can see, again, you're taking advice and you're also sailing forward. And there is, although a few problems around, we say there, a few things to sort out before we get going in, make sure then that you, like I've said, you cover and look into everything, because just a little bit of rocky turbulence there, but as the hermit's shown these lights, the card there with the bottom right-hand side card showing me that although I've got a few arrows in that boat, it's showing them there are a few problems, but they're not major. You are going forward. The devil's there to say, look, although I've got this, I can actually indulge. You know, he's tempting you. The devil is a very tempting card. And he's tempting this room. You're very tempted to go forward there. But you can break free anytime you wish. You're not tied to these ideas. You're not tied to these decisions. They're all what you're wanting to seek at the moment. Because the hermit seekers. Now, it's also, again, giving you a little bit of sleepless nights. So, although I feel so good upon your path and it looks really, really good, you know, there are opportunities are there. We've got to make sure that we complete them, well, worth completing. And don't overthink things, because anxiety can set in, stress can set in there, and we become restless through this idea. So take some time out, take some thinking time to make sure you're doing what you're right doing, because you're doing the right thing, because you want to birth your ideas. All right, so I'll leave that with you now, Aries. I do hope you've enjoyed that reading. If you do like these readings, please like and subscribe for me, and I'll keep posting them out there for you. Thank you for listening.